You are using AI wrong, or in less clickbait terms, not nearly to its full potential. So if you've ever thought, what are these AI chatbots even actually useful for? I think this video will surprise you. I'm going to show you some of my own very recent real life use cases that you might not have considered. So going forward, you'll have a better idea of what's possible. So here's one example. I was working on something where I had a spreadsheet of a bunch of different GitHub repository links, and I wanted to get the names of the accounts associated with these. Now, for this example, it doesn't matter if you've never heard of GitHub or whatever. That's not the point of this. The point is, rather than clicking on each link and going to the page and copying and pasting out the name of it, instead, I simply told the AI to make a HTML tool where I can paste in a list of GitHub account URLs and use the API to get the names and output them. And with just one prompt, both Gemini 2.5 Pro and ChatGPT 03 were able to one-shot this tool, meaning they were able to do it on the first try. And both ChatGPT and Gemini have features called Canvas where it'll output the code, but then you can also preview it if it's an HTML file in this case, and it runs right in your browser. Although, of course, you can download the file and then store it locally if you plan on using it more often. And you can see that I literally can just paste in the URL and both of them are able to get the names. So my main point for the example is you can have it generate tools in the form of a quick HTML file. It literally took me less time to just have it generate that tool in that case for one time use than it would have to go through all those links and copy it themselves. However, here's another example use case you might not have thought of, and that is having it generate a Chrome extension for a certain purpose. And again, hold on, because it's way less complicated than you probably are thinking. Because if you didn't know, a Chrome extension is basically just a few different files in a folder, and you can literally have Chrome load a Chrome extension from a folder. You don't have to publish it to the Chrome Web Store and all that. You can literally just make the files and load it into Chrome yourself. So the problem I wanted to solve was a lot of times I might take screenshots of websites and I want to hide info, but I don't want to just block out the text or delete it. In my opinion, blurring looks nicer. However, blurring is not really secure. Sometimes you can unblur stuff. So my idea was to have this extension, which randomizes the text and then blurs it. So if someone went to unblur it, it would just be gibberish anyway. Now, admittedly, this is a much later iteration of the tool. It doesn't have to be this fancy. The first version I made was way simpler. It literally just, you click on it and it randomized the text, and then I would blur it myself in Photoshop or whatever. So you could always just have the simple version, or if you want to over time, keep adding stuff to it. Just make sure that every time you have a working version, you save it as a backup. Here's a more straightforward example, another Chrome extension. So on the Gemini app, in addition to the canvas, it could also output in code blocks. But the thing is, if a code block is really long, the copy button is all the way at the top. So sometimes I'll find myself having to scroll and find where the top of this thing is. It's a first world problem, but it's kind of annoying. So my idea was just make a Chrome extension that copies that top part with the button and copies it to the bottom of the code box. So I literally just told the AI to do that, and now I have one that adds a copy button to the bottom. And yeah, it looks janky because it's supposed to be on the top, but who cares? And by the way, I did upload the files for those Chrome extensions. If you would yourself find them useful, I'll just put a link to them in the description. Now for more HTML tool examples, these I made are way more advanced. I spent a lot more time on them, but still maybe show you what's possible. The first one is what I call Unicode Inspector. Basically, you can paste in text and it shows you all the technical info about the characters in there. For example, maybe you didn't know that the astronaut emoji is actually a combination of multiple emojis, the man emoji or woman and a so-called zero width joiner, invisible character, and then the rocket emoji. So you can see cool stuff like that. Another totally different tool for you power users, you might find this useful, is a GitHub repo explorer. So it helps you look through companies like Microsoft who might have thousands of different repositories for different projects. And maybe you want to look through there and find some hidden gems for cool software they made that no one really knows about. So I made this tool that literally will fetch all the repositories and then let you search through them. And there's even a column to filter for repositories that have EXEs attached to them. So, you know, you can actually find stuff that maybe you'll actually be able to run. It's kind of like that meme of the guy who posted on Reddit. He was mad that there was no EXEs that he could just download and run. And honestly, I don't exactly blame him sometimes. And again, I do, yes, have those tools for the Unicode Inspector and the other stuff on my own repo, where anytime I come up with a browser-based tool, I'll put it on there. So again, check back in the future too. I'll put the link in the description. So I would be curious what you guys think. Did you maybe not consider having AI make tools like this? Or maybe you've been doing it for other stuff. Or maybe there's stuff that I never thought of. Let us know down in the comments. In any case, if you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. And here is the AI slop call to action of the day.
Be sure to commit assault and battery on that like button.
Now, if you want to keep watching, next, I would definitely recommend my video that I made a while ago with more use cases and examples for AI chatbots. Still very relevant if you haven't seen it before. So I'll put that link right there. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.